In Python, having arbitrary read and write accesses all throughout the program towards a single location is rather uncommon. There are languages, however, where any function that executes can access any part of the memory on purpose and sometimes by accident. This is particularly true for languages in which memory is under control by the programmer, languages such as C and C++. To illustrate why in languages such as C and C++, memory management can be a huge problem, let me show you a short piece of C code that can cause lots and lots of trouble. In C and also C++, you obtain memory by calling a special function, which is called malloc for memory allocator. When you invoke malloc, you give as an argument the number of bytes that you'd like to have for your data structure. Strictly speaking, it's the number of characters, but let's skip that. The effect of this statement is that you'll be getting a chunk of bytes, and you will get a pointer that points to the beginning of this allocated memory. What you actually have here is an array of 10 characters. You can write these characters one by one. For instance, in location number 5, let's store an X. In C, as in other languages, arrays start with an index of 0, so 5 is actually the 6th element in the array. We can also read elements from the array. For instance, we can access the 10th element of the array and store the resulting character in Y. The only problem is there is no 10th character. The array has only 10 elements, and this would be the 11th element. The behavior of a C program at this moment becomes undefined. That is, anything can happen. It is possible that some completely random value is stored in Y. This is actually the most likely outcome. It is also possible that the program immediately stops. It is also possible that your program all of a sudden transforms into an adventure game and allows you to explore the colossal caves. That's a very unlikely outcome. But keep in mind that in one release of the GNU compiler, the GNU programmers had some fun in stating, well, in undefined behavior, anything can happen, so let's simply go and make this a game. This was not very appreciated by the programmers.